So let's consider how to calculate the pH of a strong acid. HCl, hydrochloric acid, is described as a strong monobasic acid. That's because 1 mole of the acid produces 1 mole of hydrogen ions. The concentration of the acid is 1 molar. The concentration of the hydrogen ions will be the same. And here, of course, is the all-important formula that involves pH and logs, logs to the base 10. Quick memo here about logs. You might find it helpful to know that the log to the base 10 of 10 to the power of x is x. Some quick illustrations here using a range of numbers from 0.01 through to 1000. Changing those quickly then to indices, 10 to the power of minus 2 through to 10 to the power of 3. And in the middle there, 1 can be represented as 10 to the power of 0. 10 to the power of 0 is 1. And it might be worth your while pausing to see the influence of taking the logs of these small and large numbers. The log of this very small number, 10 to the minus 18, turns out to be simply minus 18. Returning to our problem then, the log of 1 is the same as the log of 10 to the 0, so the pH turns out to be 0. Let's first consider then the origin of the pH scale and its purpose. The pH scale is credited to the Danish biochemist Sorensen. It dates back to 1909 when Sorensen was a senior chemist at Carlsberg Beer. The hydrogen ion concentration had to be kept constant and had to be constantly monitored for the efficient brewing of the beer. A typical concentration of hydrogen ions might be this 0.0000158 mole per cubic decimeter, or written in standard form that would be 1.58 by 10 to the minus 5 mole per cubic decimeter. Sorensen found dealing with these numbers constantly to be tedious, these small numbers. There you see the number written in standard form, still awkward and tedious to work with. Now, if you take the negative log of a small number like this, which of course is what pH is, it's the negative log of the hydrogen ion concentration, look what it does to this number. So hopefully your calculator functions something like this. Press the log button. It also puts a bracket in, you'll see there. Enter the number 0.0000158. And you can close the brackets if you need to, and equals comes out to be minus 4.80. So the negative log of that number is minus, by a minus, 4.80. Minus by a minus is a plus, so that comes out to be a pH of 4.8. Okay, so let's try a few calculations where we work out the pH of a number of strong acids. Remember that strong acids like this one, sulfuric acid, fully dissociate. So you might like to pause and give this a go. What's the pH of a solution of sulfuric acid of concentration 0.100 mole per cubic decimeter? You'll first have to work out the concentration of hydrogen ions. So pH is the negative log of the hydrogen ion concentration. Let's see how this strong acid dissociates. It fully dissociates to produce 2 moles of hydrogen ions and a mole of sulfate ions, SO4 2-. It's described as a dibasic acid because it produces 2 moles of hydrogen ions per mole of acid. Now that means the concentration of hydrogen ions will be twice the concentration of the acid. So that's twice 0.1. So 0.2 mole per cubic decimeter is the concentration of the hydrogen ions. So we need to take the negative log of 0.2. Again, let's use the calculator for this. So press the log button and enter the number 0.200. You can close the brackets if but it's not necessary. Hit equals. And that comes out to be minus 0.70. And once again, we have a minus by a minus, so the answer is 0.7. Here's another question. Can you show why the pH of pure water is 7 at 25 degrees centigrade? Let's see how water dissociates. In water, pure water, at 25 degrees centigrade, a very, very tiny number of the water molecules will have dissociated like this to form hydrogen ions and hydroxide ions. So what's the concentration of hydrogen ions and hydroxide ions in water at 25 degrees C? Here you see 0.0000001 mole per cubic decimeter, a very low concentration. Written in standard form, 1 by 10 to the minus 7 mole per cubic decimeter. So we want to take the negative log of the hydrogen ion concentration to find the pH. What's the negative log of 10 to the minus 7? Remember that the log of 10 to the power of x is x. So what's the log of 10 to the power of minus 7? The log of 10 to the power of minus 7 is minus 7. So the negative log of 10 to the minus 7 is minus minus 7. And a minus by a minus is a plus, comes out to be 7. That's why the pH of water at 25 degrees C is 7. It's because the concentration of hydrogen ions in pure water at that temperature is 10 to the minus 7 mole per cubic decimeter. Okay, here's the next question. You might like to pause and give this a go. Remember in chemistry that the unit that we like to work with is the mole. So these other units that we have here, you should have a natural instinct to change those into moles. There are two different rearrangement triangles that are useful for these mole calculations. First of all, mole is equal to the mass divided by the relative molecular mass. And the other one, where we have a volume and concentration, you might like to use N equals CV, where N is the number of moles, C is the concentration, and V is the volume, and the volume has to be expressed in cubic decimeters. A cubic decimeter is the same as a liter, or 1,000 cubic centimeters. Worth noting these if you haven't encountered them before. So have a go. First of all, take this 50 cubic centimeters of hydrochloric acid of concentration 0.500 mole per cubic decimeter and convert that to moles. You can use that rearrangement triangle on the right. To get the number of moles, N, you multiply C by V. The rule with the rearrangement triangle is you cover what you're looking for and read what's left. So if you cover N for moles, what you're left with is C times V. So how many moles of hydrochloric acid? N equals CV. The concentration there, 0.500. We need to change the 50 cubic centimeters into cubic decimeters. There are 1,000 cubic centimeters in a cubic decimeter or a liter. So to change the 50 cubic centimeters into liters or cubic decimeters, you divide by 1,000. To divide by 1,000, you move the decimal place three places to the left. So 50 becomes 0.050. That gives us the number of moles, 0.025 moles of hydrochloric acid. Now, hydrochloric acid, HCl, is described as a monobasic acid. Keep that in mind, because the concentration of hydrogen ions will be the same as the concentration of the HCl. Next, we need to consider the fact that the acid has been diluted by adding 200 cubic centimeters of water to the 50 cubic centimeters of acid. We now have the number of moles of acid, N, and we have the volume as well. The volume is that 200 cubic centimeters of water plus the 50 cubic centimeters of acid. Total volume is 250 cubic centimeters, which you would have to change to dm cubed by dividing by 1,000. So 250 cubic centimeters, or 0.25 dm cubed. So let's work out C by dividing N by V. 0.025, the number of moles of HCl, divided by the volume in cubic decimeters, 0.25. Now the concentration of hydrogen ions will be the same as the concentration of the HCl, because HCl is a monobasic acid. That's to say, you get 1 mole of hydrogen ions produced per mole of HCl. So the concentration of hydrogen ions is 0.1 mole per cubic decimeter, or 0.1 molar. The pH then is the negative log of 0.1. Recall that 0.1 is a tenth. A tenth can be written as 10 to the power of minus 1. And the log of 10 to the x, remember, is x. So the log of 10 to the power of minus 1 is minus 1. That means that that pH, being the negative log, will be minus minus 1, which gives us 1. That's the answer. And here's the next question. Do pause and give it a go. Once again, you should have a natural tendency to turn all the units into moles. It's moles that we work with all the time in calculations. So first of all, take that 20 cubic centimeters of sulfuric acid of concentration 1 molar, or 1 mole per cubic decimeter, and convert that to moles. Again, you might consider using this rearrangement triangle on the right, or the formula N equals CV. So N equals CV, we'll need to convert the 20 cubic centimeters to cubic decimeters by dividing by 1,000. N equals CV, the concentration then is 1, and the volume in cubic decimeters is 0.02. So the number of moles of sulfuric acid is 0.02. Next, we need to take account of the fact that water has been added to the sulfuric acid to dilute it. So we go back to that same rearrangement triangle, but this time we want C. So if you cover there in the bottom right C, what are you left with? C equals N over V, N the number of moles, V the volume in cubic decimeters. So just put the figures in there. The number of moles, 0.02. The new volume, once the 900 cubic centimeters of water has been added, will be 920 cubic centimeters. Divide that by 1,000 to change it to dm cubed, 0.92. And the concentration in moles per cubic decimeter turns out to be 1 over 46. Now let's consider sulfuric acid. What's its formula? H2SO4. Now this is described as a dibasic acid. 1 mole of sulfuric acid will produce 2 moles of hydrogen ions. So the concentration of hydrogen ions will be twice the concentration of the acid. So that'll be twice that figure, 1 over 46, or 1 over 23. So we need the pH. And the pH is the negative log of the hydrogen ion concentration. Let's use a calculator here to work that pH out. Okay, so I hit the log button first of all. And you notice the calculator puts in a bracket there, so I then put 1 divided by 23. This time I need to close the bracket and just hit the equal sign. There you have the answer, minus 1.36 minus 1.36. So the negative log is going to be minus 1.36. We have a minus by a minus once again, which gives us a plus, and that's the answer. The pH is 1.36. And here's the next question. To calculate the pH of a solution formed when 25 cubic centimeters or 25 milliliters of 0.1 molar hydrochloric acid are added to 5 cubic centimeters of 0.15 molar or mole per cubic decimeter potassium hydroxide. HCl is an acid, KOH is an alkali, so this is a neutralization reaction. Let's consider the equation for the reaction. And you see they react in what we call equi or equimolar amounts. 1 mole of HCl reacts with 1 mole of KOH. Again, your natural instinct here should be to convert these units into moles. So, in terms of HCl, we have 25 cubic centimeters of 0.1 molar HCl, and we have 5 cubic centimeters of 0.15 molar KOH. Use the rearrangement triangle again to convert these into moles, or N equals CV, concentration times the volume in cubic decimeters. Pause at any time. And there's the number of moles of HCl. The concentration 0.1 multiplied by the volume in dm cubed, 0.025, comes out to be 0.0025 mole of HCl. Let's work out the number of mole of KOH. Again, the concentration times the volume in cubic decimeters. This time it turns out to be 0.00075. You can see that the HCl is in a large excess. The KOH will be entirely used up. All of the 0.00075 moles of KOH will react, and the same number of moles of HCl will react. What we need to do is to establish how many moles of HCl will be left over. Let's do that. I've subtracted the two figures there, and the number of moles of HCl left over you can see there in the bottom right, 0.00175 moles of HCl. Look back at the question and consider, what will the final volume of solution be? What volume will that number of moles of HCl left over be dissolved in? Well, if we sum the two volumes, the volume of the HCl and the volume of the KOH, we come up with 30 cubic centimeters. Now, on the bottom line there, the concentration of hydrogen ions will be the same as the concentration of the HCl, because HCl is a strong monobasic acid. So 1 mole of HCl will produce 1 mole of hydrogen ions. To get the concentration of the hydrogen ions, or HCl, again, you use C equals N over V. The number of moles left over was 0.00175. The total volume of solution was 25.530 cubic centimeters, which is 0.03 dm cubed. So I hit the log button, and the bracket is there, you'll see on the calculator. I can then do the division and make sure to close the bracket and hit equals, and there's the answer, minus 1.23. So again, we have a minus by a minus gives us a plus, and that's the answer, 1.23. And here's the final question. Calculate the pH of a solution formed when 1.32 grams of nitric acid, HNO3, are added to 750 cubic centimetres of water. So again, your instinct should be to convert the 1.32 grams of nitric acid into moles of nitric acid. How will we do that? Remember the rearrangement triangle? There in the bottom left, you can see that moles equals mass divided by relative molecular mass. So let's convert the 1.32 grams into moles. So it's the mass divided by the relative molecular mass. We need to work out the relative molecular mass of nitric acid, 1 for the hydrogen, 14 for the nitrogen, and 3 oxygens, that's 3 16s, 48. So the relative molecular mass of nitric acid is 63. We divide the mass, 1.32, by the formula mass, or relative molecular mass, 63. It comes out to be 0.02 to the second decimal place. That's the number of moles of nitric acid present. So we know the number of moles. We've also got the volume there, 750 cubic centimetres of water. So the total volume of solution is 750 cubic centimetres. Of course, we need to convert that to cubic decimetres by dividing by 1,000. So N equals CV, or C equals N over V. We're going to work out the concentration of the nitric acid, and then the concentration of hydrogen ions, and from that the pH. So the concentration is the number of moles, 0.02, divided by the volume in cubic decimeters, 0.75, and that's the concentration. That's the concentration of the nitric acid. Nitric acid, like hydrochloric acid, is a strong monobasic acid. The concentration of hydrogen ions will be the same as the concentration of the nitric acid. And dividing those figures out, 0.02 divided by 0.75 comes out to be 0.028 mole per cubic decimeter. We've got the concentration of hydrogen ions, so we can now use the calculator and work out the pH of the solution. So I press the log button first, enter the value, 0.028, and there's the answer, minus 1.55. But again, we have a minus into a minus, so the value comes out to be positive. The answer, 1.56.